Welcome students, let's start the redox reaction chapter, and in this we are going to see the balancing of chemical equations. So in the balancing of chemical equation, two different methods are there. The first method is oxidation number method. Oxidation number method. And the second method is ion electron method, or it is also called as half reaction or half equation method. Half equation method. So let's first discuss about the oxidation number method. First is the oxidation number method. Okay, oxidation number method. In the oxidation number method, we are going to write down the balancing of the equation, and for that let's start the oxidation numbers balancing method. So here the step one is that we have to form out the skeletal reaction. Okay, so I am taking an equation here to balance the equation. Zn plus HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. Okay, this is the reaction, and we have to balance this equation. So here the first reaction is to form the skeletal equation. Okay, we have to form the skeletal equation here. So the skeletal equation for the given chemical equation is Zn plus HCl gives zinc chloride, that is ZnCl2 plus hydrogen gas. Now the step 2. To give the oxidation number, okay, to find out the oxidation number for various atoms involved in the reaction. We have to find out the various atoms oxidation number here, which are present in the reaction. So here Zn plus HCl gives ZnCl2 plus H2. Okay, so in this case zinc is having 0 because Zn is solid here. Then HCl comes, HCl is a compound here, so here plus 1 for hydrogen and minus 1 for chlorine. Then next, in the case of zinc chloride, here chlorine is more electronegative, having a minus positive one, minus one charge, and zinc is having plus two charge here. And hydrogen, it is forming a biatomic molecule, so it will be having zero. Okay, oxidation state we here, it will be zero. Now here we have to next, in the next step, in the step three, we have to identify the oxidizing atom and reducing atom to be identified. Okay, we have to identify the oxidizing atom and the reducing atom here. So here zinc is oxidizing here because the oxidation number for zinc has increased from 0 to plus here. Okay, plus 2 it has been done. So here oxidation for zinc is carried out, while in the case of hydrogen the oxidation number has been reduced out here from plus 1 to 0. So it means that reduction has been carried out for the hydrogen here. Okay. Now after identifying that which of the atom has gone on oxidation and which of the atom has gone reduction, after that we will move further. And here in the step 4, the increase and decrease in number, okay, oxidation number oxidation number per atom is to be taken out here. Okay, so here we have to indicate, find out the number of oxidation number by which the oxidation number has been increased or it has been decreased out there. Okay, so here we will find out that for zinc, oxidation number has increased by 2. Okay, it has been increased by 2. And for hydrogen, the oxidation number has been reduced by 1. Okay, it has been reduced by 1. Now, in the step number 5, multiply the 2 from reducing hydrogen in the reactant part and 1 from oxidizing zinc in the reactant part. Okay, so here we will get that on multiplying 2 with the hydrogen. So here hydrogen is not alone, here hydrogen is with chlorine here. So what will happen here when we will multiply hydrogen with 2, then chlorine will also be get multiplied with 2. So hence we will find out that on doing this, the chemical equation has become balanced out here. One zinc atom on both the sides, two hydrogen atom on both the sides, 2 chlorine atoms and 2 chlorine atoms on both the sides. So hence the chemical equation has been balanced out here. So this is the total 5-step method in which we are going to balance the chemical equation by using the oxidation number method. So taking one more example, copper plus nitrate ion will form nitrite ion plus nitrite plus copper ion. Okay, so here we have to balance this equation here. Okay, we have to balance this equation here where copper is reacting with nitric acid. Okay, here copper is reacting with nitric acid and a brown gas is formed and the solution turns blue there. So we have to find out that what is the balanced chemical equation for here. So the chemical reaction is given out here, Cu plus NO3 minus 1 gives NO2 plus Cu2 plus. Okay, so here the skeletal equation, the step 1 is to find the skeletal equation. So the skeletal equation here is Cu plus NO3 minus gives NO2 plus CO2 plus. Okay, so this is the skeletal equation. Then step 2, is writing the oxidation number for each atom. Okay, how we want to write the oxidation number here for each atom. So for oxidation number for each atom, so here copper, nitrate, nitrite plus CO2 plus. Okay, so here for copper it is 0, for nitrogen it is plus 5. How I have calculated this? Here it is x. If I am taking x for nitrogen, then oxygen will be having minus 2 and minus 1 charges there. So calculation here can be x plus 3 into minus 2 is equals to minus 1. So here x minus 6 is equals to minus 1. So x is equals to 6 minus 1, which is equals to 5. So hence for nitrogen the oxidation state is plus 5 here. Okay, and for nitrogen here on the product side, here it will be minus 2. So here it will be plus 4. Okay, it will be plus 4 here. So for the monoatomic, the charge is been taken as the oxidation state only. So 2 plus is the charge. So it means that the oxidation state here is 2 plus 1. So here we can see that copper is been oxidized here. Copper is been oxidized out here. And nitrogen has been reduced out here. Nitrogen has been reduced out here. Okay. So in the step number 3, we have found out the oxidation and the reduction. In the step number 4, we have to see what is the number for the increasing in the oxidation number. Okay, what is the increase in the oxidation number? We have to find out here. So, the increase in the oxidation number is 2. Increase by 2. Oxidation number increase by 2. And here, oxidation number decreases by 2. Here it will be decreasing by 1. Okay, it is decreasing by 1 here. Okay, so here oxidation number is increased by 2 for copper and oxidation number is decreased by 1 for nitrogen here. Okay, so next step 5. We have to balance the equation. So for that we have to multiply the nitrogen in the reactant side by 2. Okay, so multiply NO3 minus 1 by 2 and Cu by 1 in the reactant side. So here we will get Cu plus 2NO3 minus gives NO2 plus Cu2 plus. But after multiplying 2 to the NO3 minus here, what we are observing that here oxygen and oxygen is to be balanced out in the right hand side. Okay, also nitrogen has become unbalanced here. So in order to balance here nitrogen and oxygen here, what we have to do, we have to just calculate that how many oxygen and how many nitrogen has been balanced out here. So 2 nitrogen is required in the right hand side, and how many oxygen will be required out here? Here it is 6 oxygen and here it is only 2 oxygens are present. Okay, so here how many it will be required out? Here it will be required out for 2 more oxygen has been left out here. So for each number of oxygen we will add the molecule of water here. So 2 oxygen has been vacant out in the reactant side, so I have added 2 water molecule here. After that also we will find out that nitrogen has been unbalanced here. So on multiplying 2 here, the nitrogen will get balanced out here. Okay, what I have done, I have just made the balancing. Once more, again, once again, I am explaining you this, that on seeing here, we will see that on multiplying 2 in the reactant side with the nitrate here, we will see that the nitrogen dioxide has been unbalanced out here. So to balance here, I will add 2 here. But after multiplying 2 with the NO2 also, what is there? Nitrogen has been balanced, but oxygen is still unbalanced here. So to balance the oxygen here, okay, on both the side, how many oxygens are required out here? 2 more oxygens are required out on the product side. So we will add, the rule is that to balance the oxygen there, we will add the required number of water molecules, as much number of oxygen has been required out there. Okay, so here 2 molecules of water has been added out here, means 2 oxygen I have added in the product side. But After this, what happened? We have seen that here now hydrogen has been unbalanced here. Now hydrogen is not present in the product reactant side. So in order to balance the reaction, we will just add the hydronium ion, that is 4H plus ion will be added in the right side. Okay, that is the product side. After doing this, we will see that 4 hydrogen, 4 hydrogen, 6 oxygen, 6 oxygen, copper one, and 2 nitrite. Okay, two nitrogen is present. So hence the chemical balancing of this equation has been completed. Next example I am taking here is Fe2O3 plus C gives Fe plus CO. Okay, so we have to balance this equation. So first skeletal equation is this only. Next is the writing of the oxidation state for these equations. So here it will be plus 3, minus 2, 0. Here iron is alone, so it will be 0 here. Carbon monoxide means plus 2 and minus 2. Now, after this, we have to see which is going reduction and where is oxidation is going. So here is reduction and here is reduction and here is oxidation. And here is reduction. So after this, what we have to do, we have to see that how much number of oxidation number has been increased out here and how much number of oxidation number has been decreased out here. Okay, so here the decreasing of the oxidation number is decreased by 3 and oxidation number is being increased by 2. Okay, it is increased by 2 here. So what we will do in the next step, we will just multiply the 3 with ferrous here, okay, Fe2O3, and 2 with the carbon atom here. Okay, 2 with the carbon atom here. So on doing this, what will happen? It means that 3 into 2 per atom. Okay, 3 into 2 means here are 2 atoms are there. Na? So it will be 3 into 2 per atom means 3 into 2. It means that total 6 oxidation number has been increased out here. Okay, so according to this, what will happen? We have to multiply Fe2O3 plus 3C gives Fe plus CO. Okay, 3C plus Fe plus CO. Because if we are seeing here that 2 is been increased out here, but 2 is been 2 atoms for 2 atoms each has increased with 2. Okay, so here it is not required to multiply 2 with iron here, but 3 will be multiplied with the carbon atom here. Okay, so after this, what will happen? After this, we have to balance out the carbon on the left hand side. So on balancing the carbon on the left hand side, we will multiply 3 with the carbon monoxide. On multiplying 3 with the carbon monoxide, we will see that here 3 oxygen, 3 oxygen, 1 iron, 2 iron. So on balance, for balancing iron, we will just multiply 2 with the iron here. Okay, so the chemically balanced equation will become Fe2O3 plus 3C plus 2Fe plus 3CO. So this is the chemically balanced equation. Next, zinc plus nitric acid will give zinc nitrate plus nitrogen dioxide plus water. We have to balance this equation. Okay, so first is, this is the skeletal equation. 0 plus 1 minus 2. Okay, so minus 2 6 minus 6 minus 6 plus 1 minus 6 plus 1 minus 5 x is equals to plus 5 then plus 5. Okay, now here Zn plus 2 and nitrogen oxygen will be having minus 2, nitrogen will be having plus 2 here, nitrogen will be having plus 2 here. Okay, here 3 is there now. Okay, sorry, minus 6 will be there, so here it will be plus 5. okay, minus 2 means from multiplying with 3, it will be minus 6. So here it will be plus 5. Okay, it will be plus 5. Next is the nitrogen dioxide. Here it will be plus 4, minus 2. And here for hydrogen, it is plus 1 and minus 2. So here on observing that, we will find out that zinc has been undergone here oxidation, and nitrogen has undergone reduction. Okay, oxidation and reduction has been found out here. Now after that, we have to find out that how many number of oxidation number has been increased. So the in the case of zinc, oxidation number increases by 2, and in the case of nitrogen, it is decreased by 1. It is decreased by 1. Okay, so as it is decreasing by 1 here and it is increasing by 2 here, here it is plus 4. Okay, it is decreasing by 1 here and there it is increasing by 2. So what we will do, we will just multiply Zn with 1 and we will multiply HNO3 with 2 here. So on multiplying Zn with 1 and HNO3 with 2, we will obtain that Zn NO3 twice plus NO2 plus H2O. Okay, so here nitrogen is 2, but here nitrogen is only 2 here, and here nitrogen is 2 plus 1, 3. Okay, so in order to balance this, what we will do, we will just multiply. It has been observed that the part of the nitrogen undergoes no change in oxidation number in the forming ZnNO3 2. So however, in order to balance the addition to 2 NO3 minus ions, add 2 HNO3 more on the left hand side. Okay, here we have to balance the NO3. So in order to balance this NO3, what we will do, we will just multiply 2 more HNO3 here. Okay, so on multiplying 2 more HNO3, what will happen? So, 2 NO3 is there. Okay, now we have to more balance out here. For one more, we require one more NO2. So, in order to balance NO2, we will multiply 2 and 2 here. So, if 2 is multiplied with the nitrogen here, then the nitric acid number will increase from 2 to 4. In that case, ZnO3 twice plus 2 NO2. Plus H2O. Now nitrogen has been balanced out here, zinc has been balanced out here, and hydrogen and oxygen is to be balanced out here. So how many oxygen is required out here? 4 3 is 12. And how many oxygens are present here? 2 3 is 6, 6 plus 4, 10, 10 and 1. Only 11 oxygen is there and 2 hydrogen is there. So on multiplying 2 here, what we will get? 4 hydrogen and 2 oxygen. Plus 4 oxygen, 6 oxygen, 6 plus 6, 12 oxygen. Okay. So, hence now this chemical equation has been balanced out. Okay. So, let's take one more example for C6H6. When reacted with O2, gives CO2 and H2O. So, this is the skeletal equation. Find out the oxidation number and reduction and oxidation for the equation here. So here we will get for C6H6, it is H6 plus 1. So here it will be minus 1, oxygen 0 because it is forming a diatomic atom, carbon minus plus 4, minus 2, hydrogen plus 1, minus 2. Okay. So on seeing here, we will observe that oxygen has undergone. Oxygen has undergone reduction and carbon has undergone oxidation here. Okay, oxygen has undergone reduction while the carbon has undergone oxidation. So after this we have to find out how many number of oxidation has been increased and decreased. So oxidation number decreases by 2, oxidation number increases by 4. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to just multiply 4 with the oxygen here. Okay, what we have to do, we have to multiply for each carbon atom if I am seeing here. So for each carbon atom, how many multiplication will be there? For 6 carbon atom, 5 into 6. Okay, 5 into 6 per atom is been multiplied here. So 5 into 6, it will be 30. Okay, 6 atoms per 6 atom. Yani 30 oxidation number is been multiplied out here. Okay, and for here for oxygen, 2 into 2, that is 4. Okay, 4 oxidation number for is been totally increased out here. So here we will do what we will do, just that C6H6 will be multiplied with 2. Okay, C6H6 will be multiplied with 2 and O2, because O2 is there, so 30 can be divided by 2, so it will be 15. So 15 will be multiplied with O2 here. So here the value will be 4C6H6 plus 15O2. It will give CO2 and H2O. Now we have to balance out here the CO2 and H2O. So 4, 6 are 24. Okay, 4, 6 are 24. So 20, sorry, 4, not 4. We have to multiply 2 here. We have to multiply 2 here. So 2, 6 are 12. So 12 carbon. If I am multiplying 12 with the carbon here, then 12 to the 24. 24 has become out. And here 30 oxygen is there. So how many oxygen is more required? 24. 6 more oxygen will be required out here. So 3H2O. Okay, so sorry, not 6H3H2O. Here 12 hydrogen is required, and so it will be 6H2O, which will give 12 to the 24, 24 plus 6, 30 oxygen. So hence the chemical equation has been balanced out here. So this is the way to balance the chemical equation by using the oxidation number method. Okay, in your book, more different questions are given out there for balancing by oxidation number method. So try it by yourself also. The more you practice this method, the more it will become clear to you. Okay, so try to practice more and more questions for this particular topic. So for today, I am ending the class here only. In the next class, we will continue this this chapter with the next topic, that is balancing of chemical equation by ion electron method.